Temple College Professional Development for all Temple College faculty and staff. Office 2010, Word Basics, Part 1, Getting Around with R. Craig Collins, Professional Development Coordinator. This workshop will introduce Word 2010, including the ribbon interface, the most used tabs and items, navigating the ribbon, customization, templates, and a few odds and ends. There are several ways to start Word. If there's a shortcut on the desktop, double-click it. If there's an icon for a Word file, double-click it. You can also right-click New Microsoft Word Document. You can use Start, All Programs, Microsoft Office, Microsoft Word 2010 to launch Word. Or right-click Word, choose Pin to Start menu to access it on the Start menu later. Why a ribbon? Ribbon versus menu. Many old-style word processors use a menu system that forces you to dig for items, often opening submenu after submenu before you find the tool you need. The ribbon in Microsoft Office products allows you to more quickly locate items by choosing from a logical group of tabs and graphically displays most of the tools you need. Note, after choosing Insert, then Auto Text, there are still 10 items that lead to more options. Why a ribbon? Menus replaced with a ribbon interface because more icons are visible at a time. The most used icons run center to left. Less frequently used items are further right. Less frequently used ribbon tabs are also to right. Again, the most commonly used items tend to be on the left. Word 2007 or Word 2010. In Word 2007, you click the Office button to create, open, or save files. In Word 2010, you click the File tab to create, open, or save files. In Word 2010, when you choose File Recent, you will see files you have recently worked on. You can click the pin icon on the right to keep that item on the list, or unpin to allow it to rotate off. The File menu tab. Aside from the standard Save, Save As, and Open, the File tab Print option combines the Print dialog box with the Print preview option. The File menu tab, Continued. The File tab also has access to other preferential settings when you select the Options icon. The Home tab. Most of the time you will want the Home tab selected. This is where basic formatting options reside. The groupings are the Clipboard section, Font section, Paragraph section, Styles, and Editing. The Home tab, Continued. Clipboard. Selected text can be cut, copied, or pasted. Select the Arrow box to open the Clipboard dialog box for more options. Font. The font area is probably the most used area on the Home tab. Used to control the font size, example 11 points. Note, there are 72 points to an inch. The font face, the shape of letters, example Calibri. The font highlight, if desired, the font color, and the font attributes, bold, italic, and underline, etc. Click the arrow box to open the font dialog box for more control over spacing. Paragraph. Key items on the top section. You may turn text into a bulleted list or a numbered list. You may increase or decrease the indentation on selected text. Key items on the lower section. You may align your text to the left, center, right, or justify text. Single or double spacing is done to paragraphs using the line spacing button. Click the arrow box to open the paragraph dialog box for more control over spacing. Styles. Styles are used to apply preset formats to selected text. Note that you may scroll through several preset styles, or click the arrow box to open the styles dialog box to see them in a list. Editing. You can search for items in your document, or search for and replace items. List. Bulleted list. Example of a bulleted list. Each item has a bullet. Each time you hit enter, a new bullet is added. Numbered list. Example of a numbered list. Each item has a number. Each time you hit enter, the next number is added. The insert tab. If you need to add something, typically you select insert. The groupings are pages, table, illustrations, links, header and footer, text, and symbols. The insert tab, pages, and tables. Pages. To insert a cover page, click the arrow to choose from many different styles, or to simply insert a blank page, or to start a new page. You may also use Control plus Enter to start a new page. Table. Used to organize content into rows and columns. To get started, click the arrow below table. Option 1. Drag your mouse to indicate how many rows and columns you wish to create. The insert tab, tables, continued. Option 2. Choose insert table to numerically choose the number of rows and columns. Note, when you select the table, a new tab appears on top of the other tabs. You may click on Design or Layout to further refine your table. Formulas. If you choose the Layout tab or Table Tools, you may insert a formula using the icon to the far right. Equals sum above will add up all the numbers in the table above the current cell. The Insert tab continued. Illustrations. Once you select to insert a picture from a file or to search and insert clip art, the image will be added where the cursor is. If you click on the picture, drag handles will appear on the edges of the image to let you scale or rotate the image. Further, once an image is clicked, a new tab appears on top of the other tabs. You may click on Format to further refine your image. Links, header, and footer. If you type in a web address, it will automatically change to a link. If you highlight text, you can click on Hyperlink and make the select word a link to a URL. Headers are items Word automatically adds to the top of a page. Footers are automatically added to the bottom of a page. Text, symbols. Text boxes will give you control over the position of a block of text in your document. You can place text boxes anywhere in the document and format them, or the box that surrounds them. The Page Layout tab. The Page Layout tab includes themes, page setup, page background, paragraph, and arrange. Page layout continued. Themes. Themes allow you to choose a pre-formatted look for the entire document, including colors, fonts, and effects, mainly for more advanced activities. Page setup. The page setup group is the most used item on this tab. Click the arrow under margins to change margins. Default is 1 inch by 1 inch. Click the arrow next to orientation to change from the default portrait to landscape. Click the arrow box to the right of page setup to open a dialog box where you can alter paper size. Page background. Page color does not print with the color, mainly for more advanced activities. Paragraph. This is a duplicate access point to controlling the spacing after a paragraph, or if the paragraph itself is single space, double space, etc. Click the arrow box to the right of paragraph to access the same dialog box you get on the Home tab when you select Paragraph. arrange. If you have inserted a text box, you may control where the text box is in relationship to the regular text here, mainly for more advanced activities. The View tab. You really only need to click on the View tab once to click the check mark next to Rulers if you would like to see the rulers. Most of the controls on the Zoom tab are duplicated in the lower right of your screen. Icons to change view and to zoom in and out. Note the word count bottom left and the duplicate views, print layout, full screen, web layout, outline and draft, and zoom lower right. Navigation topics: how to scroll through the ribbon, how to move within the document, how to select a word, a line, or a paragraph. Select with the mouse, select with keyboard shortcuts. In this next section, two helpful topics will be demonstrated: how to quickly navigate the ribbon and how to quickly move around the document, plus how to select portions of a document. To get help on an icon, hover your mouse over the icon for bubble help. To scan the ribbon, hover your mouse over the ribbon and roll the wheel mouse. To place your cursor, left click where you wish to place it. To select a word, double click the word. To select a paragraph, triple click somewhere in the paragraph. To get to the beginning of the line from the current position, press Home. To get to the end of the line from the current position, press End. To select from the insertion point to the beginning of the line, press Shift Home. To select from the insertion point to the end of the line, press Shift End. To select the entire document, press Control plus A. Customization. Before you begin, about arrows, triangles, chevrons, and dot, 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 the ellipsis. On a menu, dot, dot, dot indicates a dialog box will open to help you complete a task. On a menu, an arrow, or chevron, or triangle means click to get more options. The word Quick Access Toolbar. At the top left of Word, next to the Office button, or the line above the File tab, is the Quick Access Toolbar. By default, it has a Save icon, an Undo icon, and a Redo icon. I personally like to also have the Spell Check button there. Here's how to add an icon. The following section demonstrates how to customize the Quick Access tool. First the instructions, then a short video. Customization continued. Click the chevron arrow next to the quick access bar. Recall, arrows mean more options. From here you can customize and add. If you do not see the command you wish to add, choose More Commands. Remember, the dot 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 means a dialog box will open. I suggest choosing All Commands instead of Popular Commands. In the left column of the dialog box, click the item you wish to add, then choose Add. The list of selected commands appears. Click OK when finished. Now that you have reviewed the steps, it's time for a video demonstration. To customize the Quick Access Toolbar, click the arrow. Choose More Commands. Choose All Commands. Scroll down to the item. In this case, I'll add Spell Check. Now, click Add. You can also change the order. Click OK when finished. Note, spelling is now available. End of part one of my YouTube workshop video companion.